Hello students, welcome to today's lecture of R. Today I am going to discuss about loops in R programming. First of all, repeat loop. Now, what is the meaning of this and how can we use it? Suppose v1 is the variable. Let this value is equal to 1. Repeat, then start off curly bracket, then print v1, then v1 is equal to v1 plus 1, then if condition v1 greater than 5, then break. Now, what is the meaning of this? This one is initialization. You can say starting point. And what is the meaning of this? This one is incrementation or increment the value by 1 each time. And what about this one? This one is the condition. Means when v1 greater than 5, the execution stops. Execute the program now. Look at the output. The output is from 1 to 5. Suppose I am writing 15. It means it can print the data up to 15. Execute the program again. It can print the data up to 15. Suppose I am writing 15 over here or 10 over here. Each time I am decremented the content by 1, and here less than 2. It means the value is decremented each time by 1, and condition is v1 less than 2. Now again execute the program. It means you can print the data in reverse order. This one is the content of repeat loop. Now what about the second category? That is while loop. Later on we will discuss where to use these loops in programming. V2 is equal to 1, then while V2 less than 10, print V2 and then give the increment each time by 2. Now, what is the meaning of this? First one is initialization. Starting point. This one is the test condition. And what about this one? Increment each time by 2. Now execute this one. Initialization, then test condition, and increment each time by 1. First value is equal to 1. Up to 10, you can execute the content, but each time the execution incremented by 2, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. These are the contents of while loop. Now the third category is for loop. How to use for loop? Suppose I am using V3 by default, this content is there, that is letters from 1 to 10. Basically, these are the alphabets of English. For I in V3, here we have to use brackets. For I in V3, then start of curly braces, if I is equal to capital E, then next. And the printing of content is there. Print I. Let's execute the program now. You can print the alphabets without E. A, B, C, D, E is not there. F, G, H, I, J. Now, what is the meaning of this along with for loop? This one is the reading of the content for I in V3. Means you can read all the alphabets from 1 to 10. If I is equal to E, you can use next. Now, what is the meaning of this? It means skipping of E is there. Skipping of E is there. Now one more content is there inside this programming. Let's copy this one and paste here. Let the variable is V4. This one is the second variable. If I am using break here, now look at the change. Execute the program again. Observe the change. Starting point is from A up to the 10th alphabet. But when we reach to the alphabet E, it will break. Means the next execution is not there. In comment section, you can write the printing will not be there. When we reach E and after E, it will stop execution when we reach at E. These are the contents of loops. First is repeat, second is while loop, and third is for loop. And I am discussing for loop in two conditions. One is next and second is break. Thanks for watching my video.